Hello, and a warm welcome to the new QuickTip by JANUS Engineering. My name is Heinrich Flaum, and today I'll be showing you a trick when it comes to roughing apart with a 5-axis roughing operation. Because it's not always possible to achieve the desired result immediately with an existing surface on the workpiece. That's why we step in and demonstrate that it actually can be quite simple. Enjoy the video.
That said, we can take a closer look at our part today. As you can see, there are already some operations existing on that, mostly for facing the part. And now I would like to take a closer look at the inner geometry of it. And as you see, there are some 5-axis operations possible for that. I already have an operation existing in here that says multi-axis roughing. What settings do I have to get in here? Actually, not a lot. I just have to define the drive floor for that. And when I go into it, I also will see the main thing that we are talking about today. As in the multi-axis roughing operation, I only can specify one single floor, not multiple ones. What will happen when I select this floor in here and let the operation generate? We'll see there are now some tool paths existing, but is the result okay for me or not? Actually not, because the toolpath has been orientated along the selected drive floor, and as we have seen, it was this flat surface in here. So in this area, the operation will not get into the spaces where I want it to be. What happens if I choose this radius instead? Let's regenerate it and see the result. We see that the result now is a little bit better. We see also that the tool is doing the flat parts over here, but when it comes into this region, we see that the tool cannot reach the target in here. So the optimum for us would be one single face along all the floor of our part in here. How can we achieve that? Let me first change the application into modeling. I'm now going to surface and pick through curves. So the first edge or curve that I'm gonna pick in the tangent curves manner shall be this in here, already selected. Now I will add a new section on the opposite side, like that. And when I say OK in here, we will see that I will now have one single face in here that has this very same shape as my floor of the part. So let's return to our manufacturing now. Double click on the operation, and the neat thing about that is I don't have to pick a face that belongs to the part. I can pick any face whatsoever that I want for the drive curve, or better said, the drive floor geometry. So I now just have picked the face that we have created. I will accept with OK and we generate it again. Perfect. We now can see that the tool is reaching all the regions on the part that are necessary to manufacture here. So the flat part up here and also the tilted area down there. Okay. How does that look in the NC code context? Let me first show you the machine that I'm about to use, and maybe I will get rid of some of those sheets that I don't need for my simulations in here. So let's start the simulation. Now as the post-processor has finished its NC file, we can start the simulation, of course, with the material removal as well. Let's go. By the way, the face that we just have created is also being shown in the simulation, of course.
Just like that, we've now managed a relatively complex 5-axis roughing operation with simple steps, exactly how we wanted it to be. By the way, you can check out another quick tip on multi-axis roughing right here at this link. In this, we show you how to make a 5-axis guiding curve operation enable roughing-like behavior. As always, we appreciate a like from you and recommend subscribing to our channel so you don't miss more videos on Siemens NX. See you next time. Goodbye.
Let's make it real. JANUS Engineering.